Sir, if your jobs up.
Good morning, everyone. Good morning, dear participants. Welcome to this second day of virtual interactive session on effective preparations for the combined geoscience and geologist examination. Welcome all the participants who have joined till now, and I'll be hoping that some more will join soon. In today's program, we'll start with effective preparation for geophysics for combined geoscientist and geologist exam. This session will be followed by effective writing skills for mains by Srimati Nidhi Mishra. This will be followed by a lunch break, and we will have another eminent speaker, Sri P.V. Sukumaran, who is retired DDG, retired as a Deputy Director General in Geological Survey of India, and he happened to be in the interview board of UPSC. So he will be sharing his experience with you, and tell you how to prepare for the interview again. This interactive session with Sri P.V. Sukumaran will continue till 3:30 or quarter to 4, and then we will smoothly come in that session. We start talking with our 12 geoscientists who have joined recently, especially the four geologists, four physicists, four chemists, and along with the faculty members from GSIT Training Institute, we'll be interacting with you for about an hour or so. And at 4:30, we'll have a small valediction of this program. So I hope you will interact with all the participants, the presenters, those who are on this side of the session. We'll talk to you definitely. To begin the sessions, I'll invite Sri Siddharth Srivastav, Mr. Rahul, Ms. Sneha Kumari, and Ms. Sandhya Jagannathan, who are the toppers from the combined geoscientist examination of UPSC 2019, to tell about the effective preparation for geophysics in UPSC combined geoscientist examination. Over to you, Rahul. All the best. Please go ahead.
Thank you, sir, for this nice introduction. Good morning to all. My name is Siddharth Srivastav. I am a physicist in Geological Survey of India. Along with rest of my three colleagues, Rahul and Sneha Kumari, will be talking about preparation strategy, status, important topics regarding the examination. Combined geoscientist and geologist. The section geophysics. So before going deep into the discussion, I would like to say that you are there where we were. So by sharing our experiences, we want to reduce your time, your effort to crack this examination. I want you to just consider yourself as an upcoming officer of GSI. So like an officer, have your pen paper and write down if you get anything good in the talk, and if anywhere you get any doubt. In the of every slot, we have just open discussion for you, and you will invite to ask any queries. So now, this is the pattern of examination. All well known about this pattern. It consists of three stages: prelims, mains, followed by interview. So for next 40 to 45 minutes, we'll be talking about prelims and main section. And for interview talks, we have another session. Have patience and to be connected with us, we will just take care of this session. Okay. So now the prelim section. Total marks will be of 400. This section consists of two compulsory paper, GS and main section. GS is of 100 marks and main paper is of 300 marks. Followed by mains. So Rahul and I will be talking about prelim section. Now, so we will take care of the prelims. Rahul and I will be talking about the prelims. It will be of out of 400 total marks, and objective. It is objective in nature. So they just try to find out the what is your analytical skill in the paper. So
yeah,
now the prelim section, it is the syllabus of prelim section. It consists of six broad topic: earth geophysics, natural method in physics, third topic electromagnetism, geophysical prospecting, remote sensing and thermodynamics, physics in, and radiometry. Now, slide. Actually, there is some technical error. Prashant. Prashant has. Are you requesting to annotate the share content?
Actually, somebody is asking for annotation share content, but please wait. We cannot do right now. Just let the talk finish.
Let the talk finish.
Prashant S, please mute your mic.
All right. May I request all the participants to kindly maintain the same discipline which was maintained in yesterday. During the e-lecture sessions, be on mute. When you have query, you can unmute or put it in the chat. And for that, specific time is speaker will request you to ask any questions. This is the time when you may start asking questions. Before that, it is requested, kindly be on mute. And secondly, you do not require much annotation, so let us wait till the session ends for any such request. Thank you so much. Siddharth, you may continue, please. Thank you.
Okay. There is some technical error. We are just resolving that. Okay, so I told you earlier that this paper consists of topic solid earth geophysics, mathematical method in geophysics, electromagnetism, geophysical prospecting, remote sensing and thermodynamics, nuclear physics, and radiometry. So, why it's not changing?
You are audible. You may continue, please.
Okay. So now, among these six topics, I will be talking about major topics: solid earth geophysics, mathematical method in geophysics, and geophysical prospecting, which is rooted connected to geophysics. Now, first broad topic is solid earth geophysics. Now there is subtopics in this solid earth geophysics is looking very broad in nature, and instead of having that pre-examination, you must concentrate over all the topic. Like all the topic are important to you because they try to ask one or two question in each and every section, but still some topic are most important in these topic because the questions frequently asked in that section, number of questions in a single paper also higher than the other section. Gravity, magnetic field, elastic wave type and their propagation. In this topic, earthquake and their cause, focal depth, epicenter, intensity and magnitude scale. These are very important in nature. And they try to ask very basic question, tricky question, question which need to solve. These are Azit, just off your mic, please. So now the fundamental books which must be for the preparation of this section is Fundamental of Geophysics, authored by Williamson Lawry, authored by William Lawry, and Applied Geophysics by Telford, Introduction to Global Geophysics by CMR Flower. Okay, so as in this section, solar system, origin, formation and characteristic of the planet, there is 8 or 9 pages in William Lowry. You can go through that pages and it will just benefit to you. As I was giving the examination, I just follow those pages of William Lowry and I just get benefited and hope the same for you. Now, as I have prepared sample of the questions for you last papers, just to show you that how we must tackle the questions. Like first question, Bohr's law is associated with. So this is very basic question. This is very fundamental question directly asked from the book, that is William Lowry. Okay, so answer is in front of you, distance between two planets. So this is directly asked from the book. Now the second question, which branch of geophysics deal with the internal structure of the earth? It is not directly from the book. So how we should tackle these questions? How we just go for the answer type of questions? Like, we must go through the options. First option is active reflection seismic. Second option is active reflection seismics. Third option is passive seismology. So there is two terms used here. That active and the passive. What is the meaning of active and passive here? Active means you are using any artificial source, and passive means you are using any natural sources. So if you want to know about the internal structure of the earth, you must go the deepest source possible. And what can be deepest source? That is earth cube, and that is natural in nature. So what will the correct answer? Passive seismology. So if the question is not directly from the book what you followed, like William Lowry or Telford, then you must be tackle these questions in this way. Now, next slide. This is third question. It is looking very long, so it may be possible because of this long nature you can leave this question, but it is not like that. It is very simple in nature. Like, all the quantity is given in front of you, just calculate the moment magnitude. Okay, now what will you get? Moment magnitude will be higher than 8. So what will happen? Seismometer will just get saturated for the body wave and the surface wave. So the magnitude of the surface wave will be given by 8 and the body wave will be given by 6. Answer is very clear. So now the fourth question, the power of the earth cube of the magnitude 7 is higher than that of the 5 on the reactor scale. So difference between these two magnitude is 2. So what is the approach of solving this question? You can approach this question only when you remember the formula. So formula is also as important as your fundamental and basics are. So what is the formula? 10 into the power 1.5 into difference between the magnitude, and that comes closer to 961 times. This approach you must follow. So what have learned from these questions? Like first question, this question is directly from textbook. Second question, this was not directly from textbook, but how we must approach these type of questions. Now third question, this is looking long in nature. So how can we tackle these type of questions? Fourth question shows us that formula is also important to us. So 4 points you must be note down here, that question can be asked directly from the book. If question not asked directly from the book, we will approach through the options, and we must not leave the question by looking long into the nature. And 4, that formula is, retention of formula is very important to us. So kindly make a note, whatever means, irrespective of that, how many times you are studying, just make the notes in every time while you are studying. Even you are studying your notes, make another notes until your 60 pages notes come into the single page. So this approach must be followed to crack the examination. Now, the second broad section is mathematical method in geophysics. This is looking long in nature, but one benefit is here. If you can see that if you are here, all the students come from their bachelor background. And as you know, in geophysics, most of the candidates are from mathematics or physics background. So they already have studied all these topics. So you can be just get benefited yourself by this. By this topic, it will take hardly 10 or 12 days, 15 days to take care of this topic, to revise this topic. So just go through that, because once the question comes from here and you get solve that question, it will absolutely benefit for you. Matrix, property of matrix, they directly ask. They give four of the matrices and ask which one is orthogonal. So you must know about the property of matrix. Now, I have also some book suggestion here, like Advanced Engineering Mathematics, Erwin Kerzhik, Introduction to Engineering Mathematics, H.K. Das. So these are common books. You can go through that books and revise all the topics which you have already studied. So what I've seen in these two broad topics, that you just have to point out the most important section by yourself, by revising the paper, that which kind of question they are asking there. So revise all the topics. With that, you must keep in your mind that each and every topics are important in the pre-examination, because they try to ask at least one or two questions from each and every section. So you must be familiar with each and every topic. This is the very basic and fundamental question. It is also formula-based question. You all must be knowing about these questions, the solution of these questions. So these type of questions, they are going to ask to you. Now, the third and the last topic of the geophysics is geophysical prospect. So, as we see in the first section, as I told you, that gravity and magnetic are important to you. Like that, some fundamental principles in which section are there also important to you, like electrical method, electromagnetic method. If they are using any instrument, any approach there, and what is the basic principle behind that? Fundamental of seismic method, Snell's law, energy proportion, reflection and transmission coefficient, reflection and refraction from layer media. These all are important to you, because these are fundamental of the geophysics. You must be knowing the very basic concept of these topics. What book you must be followed for well logging? These are Petrophysics by Paul Glover, Fundamental of Well Logging Interpretation by O'Shea, and Basic Well Logging Analysis by Hoskins. So these are some books you can be easily get from the e-commerce website. And if you're not getting there, you must go for some alternative books. Like if you are not getting Paul Glover, Hoskins is also best for you. So just go for the options, whatever you may achieve easily there. So this is what the about the geophysics. I hope you have written your queries, you have written your important points. So if you have queries, then please welcome to all of you. Just ask to us. We will try to resolve all your queries. So now the session is
good morning, sir.
For you.
Sir, I am Aditya from Andhra University.
Okay.
Sir, in you discuss about the mathematical methods of geophysics.
Mathematical method.
Sir, in that you didn't explain about the preference of inversion theory.
Inversion theory. Okay. Yes, sir. So, okay. I am just taking care.
Okay, sir.
Inversion theory is very best that you must go for your class notes, okay? Because that will be sufficient for you. That will be the enough for you. If you are not getting any topics from your class note, just go through the net by using the single topic. It don't need to follow any book, but still, if you want to follow, then some books are there, like Richardson, the books by the Richardson. So you can follow the book. Otherwise, you can go through the class note, and that will be the sufficient for you. Okay.
Okay. Next question. Thank you, sir.
Okay. Welcome.
Good morning, sir.
Yeah. Good morning.
Sir, my question is that, is there any solid paper or answer paper can you like to suggest for this paper?
Sorry, Mahir, can you speak loud?
Sir, can you suggest any paper or any MCQ type books for
MCQ?
Oh. Yes, sir.
Okay. For MCQ, the best way is to solve the GATE paper, previous year GATE paper. That will be the beneficial for you. I will show you just this paper, this question. The third number question is the repeated question of the GATE paper. So if you go for the GATE paper, you will not only get the number of the MCQ question, but also it is possible that you will get the repeated question in the examination. So it will be the beneficial for you. And the next approach, what I followed in my preparation, that make a group of the people, make the group of the candidates of 5 or 6 candidates, and just have a 2 week and prepare the questions by your own self. Then what will happen? You have 5 sample of the question papers and solve them. Okay. This approach you must follow. Oh, thank you. Now next question.
Thank you, sir.
Sir, can we get previous year paper of these geophysics?
These are online available on the UPSC site, so you can get from there easily.
Okay,
thank you. I am passing this to Rahul.
Hello, sir.
For further discussion, for further speaking, for further talking. Okay, so
hello, sir. To
Rahul, please take care of the physics section.
Good morning, everyone. It was a brief introduction of geophysics part at the preliminary stage by Siddharth Srivastav. I think you get benefited out of it. I'm Rahul, geophysicist, Geological Survey of India, and I'll be talking about the physics part at the preliminary stage. So as my friend Siddharth discussed about and talked about the books strategy about the geophysics part, in the same way, I'll also be talking about the physics part. And you will know that there are 6 topics at preliminary stage. Out of those topics, 3 are from physics background. So the physics syllabus, physics subjects, you can say. And there are only 5 and 6 topics. And 120 questions are asked at the preliminary stage. Each consists of 2.5 marks. So there are 6 topics, and each topic, you can assume 20 questions and 22 questions would be asked. So in that case, you cannot leave even a single question from and single question and single part of the syllabus. So like, for example, we need to talk about these 3 topics: electromagnetism, remote sensing and thermodynamics, nuclear physics and radiometry. First, let's talk about the electromagnetism. In electromagnetism, you can see there are only 5-6 topics, and out of these, 3-4 questions would be asked from each topic. Like displacement current, Faraday's law of electromagnetism, Maxwell equations are really important. Every year and again, they would be asked. So there are 4 Maxwell equations, directly or indirectly question would be there in each examination. So you can do one thing. You can focus more on Maxwell equations, properties of displacement current, conduction current, difference between boundary conditions of electric field, magnetic field. So you can focus more on this, but you cannot leave in a single topic. And there are books that are being referred for these topics. First is Introduction to Electrodynamics, authored by Griffiths, then D.C. Tyal, Electricity and Magnetism by D.C. Tyal, and most importantly, previous year papers with solutions provided by Physics by Physics. They are freely available for GATE and GEM. And there are short notes with important formulae for competitive exam from Physics by Physics. You can also download freely there. The why I refer these two books, because sometimes this digigraphics is not being followed in some state universities. So there you can refer DCTIL, but in most of the state universities and metropolitan cities, the digigraphics is being followed. So you can go for digigraphics also. And I have three questions from the previous year examination. They are most importantly, they will not be asked again for your exam, but this will act as a source of impetus for you to prepare for this examination, and it will augment your confidence and you will go for the preparation. So first question, two charges, they are placed on a line AB and you have to find the equilibrium point. So in that equilibrium point, this is 12th base question, and you will directly apply the formula that F K Q1 Q2 by R square. So you will directly get your answer. Okay. In the similar way, as I talked about the Maxwell equations. So there are two questions which is directly asked from the Maxwell equation, which is indirectly asked from the Maxwell equation. So you can go with these two questions also. Like you can see the Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction. You know that EMF generated is directly proportional to flux change in the system. So it's d phi by dt, and phi is B into area. So dB by dt. So change in magnetic field will produce a electric field. So you can go such interpretation. Like third question, which of the following equation will remain same when we change the medium? If you look at the option A, C, and D, you will find there are mu naught, epsilon naught features in the equations. So you can say that these will be affected if we change the medium. Only equation two, which will not be changed with the change in the medium. So these are very simple questions are generally asked at the preliminary stage. So you can revise more and more MCQ. Next topic is remote sensing and thermodynamics. The most important, you can say, topics in these three equations, Stefan-Boltzmann equations, Wien's law, and Planck's law. So, and Planck's law has some important advantage. Like if we reduce Planck's law, so it can be reduced at Stefan-Boltzmann law, and at the same time, Wien's law. This is very important concept. So there are only six topics, and five questions will be generally asked from each topic. So you cannot leave any single questions. So you have to revise all the syllabus. So books for the remote sensing is Fundamentals of Remote Sensing, by authored by George Joseph, and Remote Sensing and GIS by Basudev Bhatta, and Remote Sensing for Earth Resources by D.P. Rao. And Thermodynamics and Statics, the book which is generally followed in Delhi University and other state Punjab University and all these universities are Thermal Physics by Garg, Bansal and Ghosh. Second, Satya Prakash is also referred for few topics which are not covered by Garg, Bansal, Ghosh. And previous year papers with solution from physics by physics for GATE and GEM. And there are short notes with important formulae for competitive exam, physics by physics, again for this topic also. And like in this question, I told you the first question, the total radiant emittance is given by energy density is equal to sigma a t to the power 4. So in this question is directly asked from the Stefan-Boltzmann law. As I mentioned, very important topics, directly or indirectly, they will be asked. In the second questions, it is the application of Wien's law. Wien's law says lambda b into t, temperature is equal to constant. So one lambda 1 and t1 is given, secondly lambda 2 is given, so you have to find t2. So these are very simple questions are asked. And this Planck's formula for black body radiation. So you know the Planck radiation at large wavelength reduces to Rayleigh, and short wavelength reduces to small wavelengths. So if you remember this small basic, you will be able to clear this question, and you will be able to tackle this question very easily. Okay, like nuclear physics and third topic and radiometry. In nuclear physics, you need to know the properties of the nuclear forces. One question will be generally asked at preliminary stage about the properties of the nuclear property, as we have experience of only two prelim in GSI. So for this examination, so in both the papers, question on properties of nuclear forces is asked. Binding energy, very important semi-empirical formula. You cannot leave this topic. So you have to revise and you have to solve as questions as semi-empirical formula. And one question, alpha, beta, gamma, properties of alpha, beta, gamma decay. And then again, one photoelectric and Compton effect last year, pair production was asked. In recent time, Compton effect was asked. So in next year, you can expect that photoelectric will be asked. So you can expect one and two questions will be asked generally on these topics. Right? Next is radiation detectors. Question like ionization chamber, counters, Jaeger-Müller counter, properties of these counters, and what are the physical significance of Jaeger-Müller counter. So these questions, if you revise on basic properties of the counters, you will be able to solve the questions. Like books for nuclear and particle physics is Nuclear Physics, authored by S.B. Patel, Introduction to Elementary Particle, authored by D.J. Griffiths. The source that I followed and I made notes out of it is YouTube lectures by H. Verma. There are 43-44 lectures on YouTube. I will advise you just to make notes out of it and revise these videos, because these are the most important videos. And H. Verma sir covered Kenneth S. Crane, the brilliant book written by this gentleman. So you can refer, and if you revise this book and revise this video, you need not to refer any source other than this. If your papers with solution physics by physics, this source is must. If you do MCQ, and there are a lot of practice MCQ, so if you do, you will get insight out of it. So you will feel that you have some, you will feel contented with the knowledge of the physics and practice of the MCQ. And there are short notes with important formulae for competitive exams. Yeah, so these are the level of, this is the level of question. Like first question, two spherical nuclei, this is the previous year question, so you can have some insight that what kind of questions are asked. It will it will boost your confidence. Like the two spherical nuclei have mass number 2, 16 and 64, and their radii a1 and a2. So you just need to have the ratio of a1 by a2. For this you need to remember only one formula: r is equal to r naught a to the power 1 by 3. So r naught is common in the both, but a by 3 to 216 cube root is 6, and 64 cube root is 4. So 6 by 4 directly 1.5 will be the answer. So this is very simple question. And next question at the same year, in the same year, is asked on the same formula. Like if you have the radius, what will be the radius of the nucleus with atomic mass 216, if the nucleus radius is 1.5 femtometer, you know r naught 1.5 femtometer, and r is equal to r naught a to the power 1 by 3. So 6 into 1.5, and you will get your answer. So these were the questions asked, and this is the very basic question. If you remember the factual, if you have the factual knowledge, and if you remember the rest mass energy of the electron is 0.51 mega electron volt, and in pair production two electrons are being created, so you just multiply 2 into 0.51, so you would have your answer 1.02 mega electron volt. So this is the very, these are very easy questions are generally asked. And take home tips for the prelim. Practice mock test. There is no substitute of practicing. You need to practice as many questions as you can, because MCQ, if you solve, so you will feel, you will come to know how to tackle these problems, because some problems are application based, some are factual, some are application based. So in those questions which are application based, you will come to know how to tackle those problems. And I have followed 2-3 sources for MCQ. You can also refer like this Gate Through Physics by Naveen Manaswi sir. So this is a nice book, previous year paper with solution, and some formulas and concepts are given at the initials of at the beginning of the each topic, each chapter, and revised formula. Work on both accuracy and speed. This we require at MCQ stage, and avoid silly calculation mistake, because you know the formula, you know the concept. When you go and applying, you do small calculation mistake and you end up getting your wrong answer. So and revise formulas, and glance through the entire question paper once before you start attempting the question. At the end, before passing discussion this talk to my colleagues Sneha and Sandhya for mains part, I'll request questions and queries from you, and this discussion is for open for you. Now you can ask your queries and questions. Any question, you have any doubt regarding prelim stage physics part?
Hello, sir.
Question.
I'm from geology background, and I would like to ask you what to follow for the gate exam, in which we have a part of geophysics, like how that is required.
Physics part.
Yes, sir. I'm from geology background, so there's a part of geophysics in GATE.
Okay.
So
what in that could be? You can refer basic MCQ. There is a book amazing, amazing.
Okay.
And you can ask a few these questions from fellow colleagues also. They would be talking about this in details. Like Sneha would be talking about geophysics part, so you can ask these questions related to geophysics to her also.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
Any more questions from? Okay, if I don't have any response from the participant side, so I wish you good luck. Before I pass it, talk to my colleague Sneha. I request Sneha to take on for the further talk.
Thank you, Rahul. Good morning to all the faculty members of Geological Survey of India Training Institute and my dear participants. I am Sneha, and I will be telling you on detailed examination geophysics section. And the physics section will be discussed by my colleague, Ms. Sandhya. So friends, GSI requires a lot of hard work and it should be done in a right direction. So today we are here to guide you for this. For students who are completed or pursuing their masters in geophysics discipline must have full confidence in geophysics section. I will be telling you today about the syllabus of the geophysics portion of the paper, important topics, related books, followed by sample portion. So let's get started. In the exam, there are three papers. Each paper has two sections, geophysics section and physics section, each of 100 marks. The geophysics section has four subjects. We start with the first paper, and its first subject is solid earth geophysics. Here, I have highlighted the important topics by analyzing the previous year paper. The topics are solar system and its origin, characteristics of planetary members, Earth, its rotation, figure, age of Earth, various method of determination, tectonics, gravity field of Earth, isostasy, geomagnetism, elements of Earth magnetism, internal fields, their causes. You can get all these topics in Fundamental Geophysics by William Lowry. These portions are mainly covered in Chapter 1 and 2. For paleomagnetism, polar wandering path, seafloor spreading, geophysical evidences, internal structure of Earth, variation of physical properties in the interior of the Earth are broadly given in book An Introduction to Global Geophysics by C.M.R. Fowler. These two books are very good books and standard books for geophysics subject A, solid earth geophysics. Here I have taken a sample question from previous year paper. Draw P wave velocity, S wave velocity, and density variation with depth from the surface of the Earth with a net sketch diagram. It's of 10 marks. So this you get answer from the internal structure of Earth, and you can get answer from either of these book, either from William Lowry or C.M.R. Fowler. Next subject is earthquake and engineering seismology. Important topics are earthquakes, focal depth, epicenters, Great Indian earthquakes, international scales, energy of earthquakes, elastic rebound theory, fault plane solutions, seismicity and seismotectonics of India, financial relation, velocity structure, PPBA studies, elastic waves, their propagation characteristics, diatency theory, short term, middle term, and long term predictions, seismic microgenation, and different types of seismometer. These are all the topics of well covered in Fundamental of Geophysics by William Lowry, Chapter 3. And you can also opt Microearthquake Seismology and Seismotectonics of South Asia by G.R. Kayal. I would advise you to cover only those topics from Kayal which are not covered in William Lowry. The sample question is define magnitude of the earthquake. See, friends, this is very easy question. It's a very fundamental question, and you can get answer either from this book, William Lowry or G.R. Kayal. And write an empirical relation between magnitude and intensity. This is given in William Lowry book. That is Imax is equals to 1.5 ms minus 1.8 log 10h plus 1.7, where Imax is the intensity of the earthquake, ms is the surface wave magnitude, and s is the focal depth. Third subject is mathematical methods in geophysics. Its important topics are properties of scalar, vector, and tensors, element of the vector analysis, gradient, divergence, curl, Gauss divergence theorem, Stokes theorem, or the solution of Laplace equation in Cartesian, cylindrical, and spherical polar coordinate. These sections are well given in mathematical physics by H.K. Das. And further, current and potential in Earth, basic concept, equation of electromagnetism, equation is boundary condition, polarization, EM field of loops of wire on half space, multilayer media, impedance and applications are well given in introduction to electrodynamics by D.J. Griffith. And I would suggest you to practice numerical from these two books as much as you can, because it has been observed that they generally ask numericals from section. Here the sample question is, see, this is a very basic question, Maxwell equation for free space in differential integral form. It's very well given in either D.J. Griffith or H.K. Das. You can take a reference from either of these books. Geophysical inversion. This is the last subject of first paper. These important topics are basic definition of inversion with application to geophysics, formulation of inverse problem, inverse problem, least square solution, minimum norm solution, constraint and linear last square inversion, review of matrix theory, model and data space, up to single value decomposition. These parts are well covered in geophysics data analysis, discrete inverse theory by William Mencken. Further, generalized inverse, Gauss-Newton method, steep and descent gradient method, all the local optimization and global optimization techniques. You can either take reference from internet source or your college note. I would advise you, if you have a geophysical inversion as a subject in your semester, then go for class notes. Here's a sample question. Define single value decomposition and verify the SVD given matrix. It's a very easy question and it's given in William Mencke. And you have also read in your semester. You have a Jacobian matrix. G is equals to U, Q, V power, V transpose, where U is your orthogonal matrix, Q is your diagonal matrix, and again, V transpose is your orthogonal matrix. Just put this matrix into your formula and you will get your answer. So friend, this is very easy and it's of 7 months. Coming to our second paper, subject, that is geophysical potential field, gravity and magnetic. Here important topics are principle of gravity and magnetic methods, geoid, spheroid, nature of gravity and its variation, intensity of magnetization, inductions, magnetic potential and its relation to field, origin of magnetic anomaly, Poisson relation, accessibility, magnetic minerals, rock classification, natural remnant magnetization, airborne magnetic survey and magnetic gradient survey, seaborne survey, gravity and magnetic reduction data, IGF correction, and separation for regional residual anomalies, ambiguity in interpretation. Again, I would recommend for this topic, William Lawry book, mainly chapter 2 and 5. And you can also take reference from book Applied Geophysics by Telford or An Introduction to Geophysical Exploration by Philip Carey. And I would advise you to practice numericals for this section from Gate book by Amrit Singh. Here's a sample question. This is very easy and very fundamental. Draw and explain the gravity and magnetic anomaly curve over a semi-infinite horizontal sheet structure using level diagram. It is very well given in Telford book. This is the subject of paper 2, electrical and electromagnetic methods. The main topics are resistivity method, fundamental laws, vertical electrical sounding, origin and application of self potential survey, origin of induced polarization and its type, IP, chargeability, pulsating frequency effect, IP induced polarization, and dipole theory of IP. Electromagnetic method, magnetoric method, it's a passive and active source, Maxwell equations, wave equations, all the types of method like a deep angle method, Thurm method, moving source we call as a Slingram method, AFMG, audio frequency magnetoric method, and vertical loop method, interface method, EM profiling and sounding, and principle of ground penetrating radar, origin and characteristics of magnetoric field. All these topics will get in Telford, and some parts are also to be read from Lawry chapter 4. And for the magnetoric I would advise you to follow mandatory practical mandatories by Simpson and Barr, because this books is stick to the syllabus, GSL syllabus, and it's very nicely and up to the point, up to the syllabus is given in this book by Simpson and Barr, practical mandatory. Take the sample questions. Very fundamental question is given in Telford. Spin induced polarization in terms of membrane and electrode polarization, and define the term chargeability and metal factor. This question is of 10 marks. So you can easily score by attempting this question. The third topic is seismic prospecting. And important topics are basic principle of seismic method, reflection, refraction, its coefficient, and propagation mode of exploration, seismology, seismic data acquisitions, sources of energy, geophones, geometric array, instrumentation part, travel time curves, correction, NMO corrections, CDP, data processing correction, and seismic topography. For seismic data acquisition, I would advise you to opt exploration by Brian J. Evans. And for tomography, you can take reference from William Laurie. And for the basic principle up to the reflection and transmission coefficient are nicely covered in William Laurie. And for processing interpretation, go for your class notes. Or either you can do from Dobry and exploration geophase by Gadala and Fizer. These two books are very good books. And you can either go any of these books. And again, practice numericals from the seismic prospecting, because it has been observed that they frequently asked a numerical question from this part. Here the sample question is, describe the methodology for common midpoint or roll along shooting in seismic reflection survey with suitable diagram. It is given in William Laurie book. So, and it is up to 15 marks. So you can easily do this question. Moving forward, the core subject of second paper, Borehole geophysics, that is principle of well logging, and its highlighted topics are fundamental concept in borehole geophysics, its conditions, properties of reservoir rock formation, formation parameters, their relationships, formation factor, or the porosity, permeability, water saturation, irreducible water saturation, hydrocarbon saturation, residual hydrocarbon saturation, Archies and Humble equations, and the all the types of logs, either open hole or cased hole, like SP log, resistivity, micro resistivity log, acoustic impedance and propagation logs, temperature logs, caliper log. There is a standard book for well logging, that is Spectrophysics by Paul Grover. Or for advanced log, you can take reference from Fundamental of Well Logging Interpretation by Osera. And you can practice numerical from these two books also. Here is a sample question. What do you understand by potential log? It is you find the answer of this question in Paul Grover chapter. There is a separate chapter of self-potential log. So I would advise you to please go through thoroughly with this book, Paul Grover or Osera. Here come to the third paper. This is the last paper, and it has also four subjects. The first subject is radiometric exploration, A1 geophysical survey for geological mapping. And topics are radioactive decay process, units, radioactivity of rocks and minerals, instruments, medicine chamber, GM counter, gamma ray spectrometer, radiometric prospecting for mineral exploration, its environmental applications, or its logging methods, its radiometric dating techniques, and A1 geophysical survey, planning of survey, sensor, data correction, application in geological mapping, interpretation of maps, identification of structure features, altered zones. You can cover this portion of the syllabus from book William Laurie, chapter 4, or from Telford, chapter 10. This instrumentation part are very well given in Telford, chapter 10. And for airborne surveys, I would suggest you to go with the paper Airborne Geophysics and the Indian Scenario by B.S.R. Murthy. It is easily available online, so you can download from online. And here is a sample question. What is radioactive cyst? Is a very basic question, and it is given in Telford. And it has been asked for 10 marks. So you can easily score this type of question. It's the third subject, that is the geophysical signal processing, and its important topics are various types of signals, sampling theorem, aliasing effect, Fourier series and transform, its properties, auto and cross relation, delta functions, jet transformers properties, inverse jet transform, all the types of filters, that is low pass and high filters, and regional residual separations, continuation, upward or downward continuations, evolution derivative, that is first and second derivative, reduction to pole and equator, and last, earth as a low pass filter. One standard book will do this job, and I have listed here the signal analysis by Tarun Kumar Rawat. It's a very good book, and I would suggest you to go, please go thoroughly with this book. And for regional residual separation, up to the earth as a low pass filter can be found in Telford, Robin or Laurie. Either of these three books will do the job. And for regional residual separation, page number 84, William Laurie is given there. And in page 26, Telford is also given in Telford book also. And for the continuation part, you can take reference from page 144 from Kieran Brooks. And here is the sample question. This is a very basic here. Yeah, describe inverse jet transform and derive the expression for inverse jet transform using the difference method. And up to 5 marks. You can get answer from this Tarun Kumar Rawat. This is the last subject of third paper, that is the remote sensing and GIS applications. And important topics are fundamental concept of remote sensing, electromagnetic radiation spectrum, and frequency wavelength relationship, Boltzmann-Wendt's law, electromagnetic energy, its interaction with the atmosphere and its with terrain features, geosynchronous and synchronous orbits, resolution, thermal scanners, microwave, remote sensing, fundamental of image processing, and interpretation for geological application. Here I have listed three books. These three books are the fundamental books, and you can open any of these books. Fundamental of remote sensing by Geo Joseph, remote sensing and GIS by Vasudev Bhatta, remote sensing for earth resources by T.P. Rao. Here, this is a sample question. Explain geostationary satellite orbits and the sun synchronous satellite orbits and the application in remote sensing of 10 marks. Here is the sample answer. See, first write the subheading, like they ask for geostationary satellite orbits. Try to answer in plate form and separate application. You can write separate application in remote sensing. Then separate of sun synchronous satellite orbit, then application. Try to supplement your answer with dependent diagram. So that's all from my side. Gather all the resources.
Sugata Kumar Sinha, please mute your microphone.
Gather all the resources. Start believing in yourself and start preparing for today. So if you have any queries or doubts in your mind, you may please ask.
Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning.
Ma'am, can you explain about the marine geophysics, which topics you have to cover? You didn't explain that thing for marine geophysics.
For marine geophysics, these are the important topics. Sorry, I skipped this. It's a combination of Laurie, you can take a reference from the internet source also for introduction to seafloor features, physiography, division of seafloor, continental shelves, and abyssal plains, and oceanic anomalies, seafloor spreading, Wien-Mathieu hypothesis. We have done hydrophone processing, data density interpretation, and seabed mapping, seabed sampling, navigation method, and position location method. This part is well given in Evans. A reference from internet also. Any other question, please?
Script part, we have to write it. Where's our description part in May's exam?
Always try to answer in point, in bullet forms, okay? Precise and in bullet form. And supplement your, always try to supplement your answer with well-depicted diagram.
And we can use color pencils in the examination point of view in mains.
No color pencil, simple normal Nataraj pencil. And you can use a single for heading, you can use a black pen. Yeah. And for writing answer, you can use blue
black
pen.
Is not advisable.
Thank
Any
you.
Any other queries? Okay, welcome. Any other queries, please?
Ma'am, good morning, ma'am.
Yes. Good morning. Yes, Anindita.
Yes, ma'am, I have a query about the geophysics portion which we get.
Sorry, your voice is not audible. Your voice is fluctuating, Anilita. Your voice is not clear. Chat section. Yes, yes. You can type your queries in chat section. I will answer that. Okay. Okay. Now I am passing to my. Yes, yes.
Hello, ma'am. Good morning, ma'am. Ma'am, my name is Shivali Chaudhary from Kurukshetra University. Ma'am, I want to ask, is there a preferred way of going through the books? Like, if first I go through the Lorry, then to the Telford, because this book will supplement the other book, or I can choose any.
You can clear your basic from either of this book, either William Lorry or Telford. Just try to make your notes, handwritten notes, because handwritten notes is very easy to memorize. Any other question, please? Okay, now I am passing to my colleague, Miss Sandhya, and she will be talking about the physics portion. Sandhya, please.
My name is Sandhya Jagannathan, and I'll be covering the physics pattern and syllabus for the mains examination. The difference between the prelims and the mains is that in the prelims, these overlapping subjects are in more condensed format, whereas in the mains they are given in more detail. So as both derivations and numericals feature in the mains part of the examination, hence these topics are need to be prepared in more detail. So the mains examination has three papers. In the first paper we have four subjects, and the first subject is mathematical methods of physics. And it is one of the most important topics because it overlaps with the geophysics syllabus as well. The important topics in this paper is complex variables and analysis, vector algebra, vector calculus, linear algebra, and matrices. And for these topics, one can refer to Advanced Engineering Mathematics by Irvin Kresik, or Introduction to Engineering Mathematics by H.K. Das. And for numericals, one can refer to Shom's Outline series by Spiegel. Looking at past year papers, we see that a lot of questions come from contour integration or roots of differential equation or gradient divergence curl of vectors. Hence, more emphasis need to be given to these topics. Moving on, the next subject is electrodynamics. And in this subject, we find that the important topics are Laplace and Poisson equations, Faraday law of electromagnetic induction, electromagnetic vector and scalar potentials. They're standard textbooks for these topics, and this is Introduction to Electrodynamics by DJ Griffiths. This book has various numericals and practice questions, so and it's also available in the market. One can refer to this book, and further, one can also refer to Electricity and Magnetism by Purcell. Maxwell equations is one of the most important topics in this subject, because a lot of questions come from this topic, and a question has come each year, so more emphasis need to be given to this topic. In continuation of electrodynamics, we have electromagnetic theory, and the same books can be referred for this topic as well, that is DJ Griffiths or Purcell. Questions on propagation of EM waves or boundary conditions come from this topic. The fourth subject in this paper is introductory atmospheric and space physics. And the ionospheric physics part can be covered from Fundamentals of Geophysics by William Lorry. And for GPS and its basics, online resources can be referred to. The important topics are as ionospheric layers or plasma physics, which is one of the subtopics in this subject, is very important because questions on plasma frequency also come from this subject. And sources of errors of GPS is one of the most frequently asked questions from this topic. Paper two of the mains examination, we have the first subject, which is classical mechanics. And in classical mechanics, we have the important topics are Lagrangian, Hamiltonian, special theory of relativity, moment of inertia, and the various books available for classical mechanics, which are standard textbooks in various universities. So we have an introduction to mechanics by Kleppner and Kalankov, which can be referred to mechanics of particles and rigid bodies. And further, if you want to understand the subject in detail, you can refer to Landau, Lifshitz, and Goldstein. D.S. Mathur is also one of the most standard textbooks in this subject. For introduction to special relativity, you can follow Introduction to Electrodynamics by D.J. Griffiths or Resnick. You can also refer to Dyer's physics notes, which is available online. Questions from Lagrangian Hamiltonian, such as the one given here, are asked frequently. The second subject is thermodynamics and statistical physics. And the most important topics are blackbody radiation, quantum statistics, Planck's radiation law. Various questions are asked from these topics. Further questions on like entropy and partition function are also asked. So a special emphasis need to be given to these topics. The list of books for this topic include Thermodynamics and Statistical Mechanics by Richard Fitzpatrick and Thermal Physics by Gerd Bunsell and Ghosh. The third topic is atomic and molecular physics, and questions from LS and JJ coupling, atomic molecular spectra, and the Stern-Gerlach experiment are asked frequently. And for this, for these important topics, one can refer to atomic and molecular physics by Banwell and Rajkumar. So, for example, the sample question here is asking about calculating moment of inertia and internuclear separation. So, questions from molecular spectra are asked frequently. In the fourth subject, we have nuclear physics, and in nuclear physics, we have questions from whether this reaction is feasible or not, or elementary particles and parity conservation or binding energy liquid drop model are asked frequently. And for basic understanding, one can refer to Concepts of Modern Physics by Arthur Beiser, or for further understanding, can refer to Introductory Nuclear Physics by K.S. Gray. And elementary particles is given very nicely in D.J. Griffiths. So Introduction to Elementary Particles by D.J. Griffiths is a standard textbook. One can also refer to that. In the third paper, we have the first subject is solid state physics and basic electronics. And in solid state physics, you can it's very important to study the different crystal systems, and questions from scanning and difference between scanning transmission electron microscopes are asked repetitively. Further questions on like different kinds of amplifiers or operational amplifiers and FET, JD, they are asked frequently. And for this, you can also refer to Charles Kittle, which is Introduction to Solid State Physics. And you can also refer to the other books mentioned here. We have observed that questions on reciprocal lattice also come frequently. So emphasis and focus need to be given on these topics. And the second subject, we have laser systems. And in laser systems, one needs to focus on different types of lasers, Einstein's A and B coefficients, different rate equations, and advanced topics such as questions come also from these advanced topics such as laser cavity modes, mode selection. And for these topics, one can refer to Fundamentals and Applications, Ghatak and Thyagarajan, which is a standard textbook. And also, you can also refer to Concepts of Physics, F.C. Verma. So for example, a sample question like establish the Einstein coefficients and the relation in laser, which is of 10 marks, it comes frequently. In the third subject, we have digital electronics, radar systems, and satellite communications. So the important topics are logic gates and truth tables, where direct questions from logic gates come. You should also focus on radar systems and different frequency, satellite frequency bands, different satellite orbits, and their inclinations. For digital electronics, you can follow Floyd, Boylestad, and Molvino-Leach. And for radar systems and satellite communications, the various online resources. And you can also refer to this Introduction to Satellite Communication by Bruce Elbert. So a sample question like give the logic symbols and two tables of a two-input NOR gate for five markers. This is a very standard question that we see in the physics part of the examination. The last subject in this paper is quantum mechanics, which is an advanced subject for many. But if you focus on these important topics such as harmonic oscillator, eigenvalues and eigenfunctions, particle in a box, Dirac's Brian-Kitt notation. So if you focus on the linear algebra part of the quantum mechanics, which is given in MCGen. It'd be very beneficial for you. Further, you can also refer to Introduction to Quantum Mechanics by D.J. Griffiths, or you can also follow Quantum Mechanics by Ghatak and Loknathan. So if you focus on these topics, it will help you score better in the examination. So for the sample question, for example, if you have a sample question like discuss quantum mechanically, the problem of a one-dimensional linear harmonic oscillator, we have given a sample answer here. So the way to approach this question is first you have to introduce the problem. You have to write the problem first, and then you systematically go on building the answer. And it's important to know that you have to number the equations. You have to write the steps in detail. You have to box important equations, and you have to give correct explanations, proper explanation for any additional questions asked in the same question. But it's also important to remember to stick to the 2-page limit. So that's all from our side. Thank you for listening. And before closing the session, if there are any questions, we'll be happy to answer them. Thank you.
Good morning, ma'am. Ma'am, isn't any sectional cutoff is there for mains for geophysics and physics?
Sectional cutoff. There is no sectional cutoff.
We need to attempt all the questions from which you have given from the paper.
No. There are choices available. You can they give choices to in both the sections.
Okay. Separately. We have to maintain the ratio from the geophysics and physics. We have to give the same. Which are given for five in the geophysics, in the physics are five.
There are three questions to be attempted from both sections, and two questions are compulsory.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you.
Hello.
Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning, ma'am. Ma'am, I am from geology background, so how should I proceed for this vast syllabus of physics, sir?
You're from geology background.
Yes, ma'am.
I mean, you'll be attempting the geophysics paper, are you saying?
Yes, ma'am. I have done BSc honors from geology, and now I'm pursuing geophysics second year.
Okay.
So how I should go for this physics section?
Okay. So if you look at the three papers, right? So if you focus on certain topics which are covered in your bachelor's itself, like mathematical methods, which I have mentioned. So the important topics in mathematical physics, which you, if you focus on it, you'll be able to score better. And the certain topics like electronics, which are also covered in bachelor's, or thermodynamics, right? So if you focus on those subjects, it'll be easier to score. But if you refer to the standard textbooks, I mean, it's important to cover all these topics mentioned in the syllabus. So just gather your resources first, gather all the books that are referred to, and then you can systematically study these topics from these books, and also look at past year question papers also. That will help you to gauge it better.
Okay.
Good
morning, ma'am. I have a question.
Good morning, ma'am. I have a question.
Yes. Ma'am, can you and others
share
what was generation
strategy? I will request Anshuman and others to kindly mute so that the voice does not echo. Yes, ma'am, you may please continue your question. Thank you.
Yes, ma'am. I was asking, could you and others from the panel please share what strategy worked out best for you for preparation and while attempting the actual paper in exam? Like which section you approached first and so on?
Actually, if you are from physics background and you are preparing for this exam, so just go for the physics part first. Because in geophysics part, you have to be selective enough to choose the questions out of 4 questions, because there are choices. Like you have to do 2 questions out of 4 questions given in the examination. So in that case, you can choose the best topic, topic you know. Like there are 4 topics: nuclear physics, atomic molecular physics. So if you have the nuclear and particle physics on your fingertips, so you can go solving for that question only. And for geophysics part, it's also the same.
Good morning.
Good morning. Yes, please go ahead.
How to tackle mathematical questions in geophysics part and physics part, ma'am? Any separate book for the mathematical questions?
I have started my session that just go for the gate book by Amrit Singh, sir. Amrit Singh. There is a gate book and it contains concentrated questions and answer. So try to solve and practice as much as you can from gate book.
Yeah, you can also read Chedas and Shams outline series.
For mathematical, you can go for H.K. Das and Irving Krasik.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
Okay.
Are there any more questions? Felix, there are no more questions.
Yeah, Jagdish, do you want to ask something? Jagdish, see?
No, madam.
Okay, I thought he's trying to speak. Fine. So, are there any more questions, please, for the physics or the geophysics part?
Ma'am, ask that question out in the chat box.
Be slightly loud, please.
Yeah, ma'am, audible.
Yeah.
Anindita, I will reply soon in chat box. Okay.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay.
Ma'am, I have a question. Hello.
Yes, please speak.
Actually, it's the same question. It was written by Mihir that which type of question is generally more asked in the geophysical signal processing portion in
geophysics? It's a basic question like Fourier transform, Z transform, Fourier series, solve the Fourier series. They are very fundamental questions, and these questions are generally covered. Examples of these questions are generally covered in Tarun Kumar Rawat. I have featured a book in my session. So please go through this book.
For signal processing, you must go through the previous year paper of GSI. Okay, that will be the beneficial for you. Means they are going to ask a very fundamental numerical type of question from. So you must go through that previous year questions paper.
Apart from previous year paper, you can go with the books also that I have suggested you. Okay. Any question?
Hello, good morning, ma'am.
Good morning.
Ma'am, what is the interview panel for the, especially for geophysics students? How it will be? Interview panel.
That will be discussed in next session. So please be with us, okay?
We have arranged a session for interview talks, yeah. So have patience and kindly just go for that, okay? Okay, okay.
So thank you all for carefully listening. And me, Sneha, along with my colleagues, Siddharth, Rahul, and Sandhya.
Yeah. All the best for all the best to everyone.
Thank you. Thank you, the entire team from the geophysics stream. May I express the sincerest gratitude and thanks for taking out time and explaining to the aspirants of the UPSC Combined Geoscientist Examination. So Siddharth, Rahul, Sneha and Snigdha, Sandhya, all four of you have tried to explain to the best possible extent regarding the syllabus, the reference material, as well as the study techniques to appear for the geophysics stream part in the prelims as well as the mains examination. Thank you so much. I'm sure it will be of immense benefit to the participants who have joined this virtual interactive session. And it will also prove useful for any of the aspirants who will be appearing for the exam, either the next year or who will be writing the exam for this particular session. And it will definitely prove of immense use when you are appearing for the interview part. So thank you all. Now we will have a very short break. This is just to give a small break so that you can have some water. And after 5 minutes, we will be starting with the session on answer writing skills. How to avoid some common mistakes while appearing for the examination. This session will be taken by me. So I will request the participants to continue to stay with us, be in the meeting, but you can have a break of 5 minutes and then we will start with the next session. Thank you to all. Please continue in the session. We'll begin in 5 minutes. Thank you so much.
Video after that.